continue with our carbon and compost chapter. Today we are going to study the next topic, the difference between saturated and unsaturated compost. So this is a very important 3-mark question. What is the difference between saturated and unsaturated compost? Okay, so one side you can write saturated and another side you can write unsaturated compost. Saturated compost and unsaturated compost. They can also ask this question in another way. They can also ask this as difference between butter and cooking oil. Butter and cooking oil. Okay, so either way they can ask the question. So first, what do you mean by saturated compost and what do you mean by unsaturated compost? Saturated compounds means the carbon compounds which are having only single bond. Carbon compounds which has only single bond. The carbon compounds which has only single bond. Single bond irukkira compounds ellame, they are carbon irukkira single bond compounds. They are all saturated compounds. Okay. So unsaturated compounds means the carbon compounds. The carbon compounds which has double bond or triple bond, which has double bond or triple bond, it is called as unsaturated compound. So if the carbon compound is having only single bond, it is called as saturated compound. If it is having double bond or triple bond, it is called as unsaturated compound. So example we will write, example CH3 single bond CH3. What is the name of this compound? 2 carbons. So each single bond. So ethane. So the name of the compound is ethane. So for this the example we can write CH2 double bond CH2. So 2 carbons. So each double bond means ethane. Or we can write CH triple bond CH. 2 carbons means E triple bond, so ethane. Okay, so these are all the examples for saturated and unsaturated compounds. Okay, so now the third point. The saturated compounds, saturated carbon compounds, they will have more number of hydrogens, but the unsaturated compounds will have less number of hydrogens. So the saturated compounds will have more number of hydrogens. Okay, and the unsaturated compounds will have less number of hydrogens. The next point, more hydrogens are there. You know, hydrogen will burn nicely. Yes or no? Hydrogen will burn very nicely. Okay. So more hydrogens are there means this compounds will burn very nicely and it will give complete combustion. okay, it will give complete combustion. So more number of hydrogens means it will burn completely, it will give complete combustion. So saturated hydrocarbons, it will give complete combustion. It will give complete combustion. Okay? Whereas unsaturated, they are having only less number of hydrogens. Yes or no? So less number of hydrogens means they will not give complete combustion. They will give incomplete combustion. They will give incomplete combustion. They will give complete combustion and they will give incomplete combustion. Complete combustion means already in 8th standard combustion and flame lesson you have studied. If something is giving complete combustion, it will burn with a blue color flame. Okay. If someone is giving incomplete combustion, it will give a yellow color flame. Okay. So saturated compounds are giving complete combustion, so it will burn with a blue flame. It will burn with a blue color flame. Okay. Unsaturated compounds will give incomplete combustion, so they will burn with a yellow flame with a black color smoke. Have you seen a candle flame? Yellow flame with black color smoke. Okay. So such flame is called as sooty flame. So it burns with a sooty flame. It burns with a sooty flame. So what do you mean by a sooty flame? Sooty flame means a yellow color flame with black smoke. Yellow color flame with black smoke. It is called as the sooty flame. Okay? Understood? So next one. This point which I am going to write now, it is your in your deleted syllabus, but we have to write that point. Okay. So saturated compounds, they will give substitution reaction. They will give substitution reaction. Okay. What is substitution reaction is in your deleted syllabus, so you do not know what is that. Okay. So whereas unsaturated compounds will give addition reaction. They will give addition reaction. Okay. Saturated compounds will give substitution reaction and unsaturated compounds will give addition reaction. So the last point is a very very important point. Okay. So there is one solution called as bromine water. Bromine, the formula is Br2. There is a solution called as bromine water. Okay. Bromine is a liquid non-metal. I hope you studied in metals and non-metals lesson. Bromine is the only non-metal which is in the liquid state. Okay. So bromine, you have to mix it with water. It is called as bromine water. Okay. So this bromine water, it will be in brown color. What is the color of bromine water? Brown color. Okay. Suppose if you pour this bromine water in any saturated compound, if you pour the brown color bromine water in any saturated compound, the color of the bromine water will not fade. It will remain the same. Okay. So we can say that saturated compounds, they will not decolorize. They will not decolorize bromine water. They will not decolorize bromine water. Whereas unsaturated compound, they will decolorize bromine water. They will decolorize bromine water. Understood? So these are the differences between saturated and unsaturated compounds. Very important question. Okay? So the next one is, you must know a definition. What are hydrocarbons? What are hydrocarbons? Hydro means hydrogen. Carbon means carbon, you know. Okay. So the compounds which have only carbon and hydrogen, they are called as hydrocarbons. So the compounds that contain only carbon and hydrogen. The compounds that contain only carbon and hydrogen, they are called as hydrocarbons. Understood? So the hydrocarbons only, they are divided into two types. One is saturated hydrocarbons. Now only we study what is saturated. Yes or no? Saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. So what do you mean by hydrocarbons? The compounds that contain only carbon and hydrogen, they are called as hydrocarbons. They can be divided into two types, saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. We studied what is saturated, we studied what is unsaturated. Okay, so now we will move to the next topic. So next topic is isomerism. Before going to isomerism, you must know how to find the molecular formula of the compounds. Okay, so finding the molecular formula of the compounds. Finding the molecular formula of the compounds. Okay, so we are going to find the molecular formula of the compounds. How to find the molecular formula? For example, suppose if I take a compound like this, CH3 single bond CH3. Okay, so what is the name of this compound? Two carbons, so eth. Okay, single bond means ene, so it is ethane. Ethane is the name of this compound. So how to write the molecular formula for this? Molecular formula means you have to count everything and write. Okay, so carbon, first you have to write what are the elements present. What are all present here? Carbon is present, hydrogen is present. Okay, how many carbons are present? How many carbons are present? Two carbons are present. So it is C2. Okay, how many hydrogens are present? 3 plus 3, 6. So H6. So C2H6. So ethane, you can write it as CH3 single bond CH3, and you can also write it as C2H6. C2H6, if they give also, it is ethane only. But what is the difference? This is the structural formula, this is the molecular formula. We will call this a structural formula, we will call this as molecular formula. Okay, suppose if it is like this, CH triple bond CH, what is the name of this? Ethan. Two carbons, so eth. Okay, triple bond means ion, so it is ethyne. So what will be the molecular formula for this? C2H2. So C2H2 also, it is ethyne only. But this is structural formula, this is molecular formula. So understood what how to write the molecular formula of the compounds. Now we will go to our topic, isomerism. What is isomerism? This is also a very important 3-mark question. Okay, so isomerism means, or if they will ask what are isomers, like that they will ask the question. They will ask what is isomerism, or they will ask what are isomers. So isomers means the compounds that have same molecular formula. The compounds that have same molecular formula but different structural formula. But different structural formula. Same molecular formula but different structural formula. They are called as isomers. So what are isomers? Isomers means the compounds which have same molecular formula but different structural formula. Okay, so we are going to draw the isomers of three compounds. One is butane. The next one we are going to draw the isomers of pentane. And then we are going to draw the isomers of hexane. So they will tell you in the exam, they will ask you the question like this. Okay, what are isomers? Draw the isomers of butane. Or they will ask, what are isomers? Draw the isomers of pentane. What are isomers? Draw the isomers of hexane. Anyone they will ask. Okay, so first we will draw the isomers of butane. Okay, isomers of butane. So first butane, what is the formula for butane? What is the formula for butane? Bute means how many carbons will come? 4 carbons will come. So 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. And ane means it is single bond. So you have to put single bond everywhere. Okay, so remaining what I should do? I should fill it with hydrogens. Okay, so this carbon is having only one bond, so remaining it needs 3 bonds. So I will be putting 3 hydrogens. This carbon is having 2 bonds, so remaining it needs 2 more bonds, so I will put 2 more hydrogens. This carbon is also having 2 bonds, remaining it needs 2 more bonds, so I will put 2 more hydrogens. Okay, so this carbon is having only 1 bond, so remaining 3 bond it needs, so I will put 3 hydrogens. Okay, so this is called as what? Butane. Okay, so what is the molecular formula for butane? 1, 2, 3, 4. So C4. Hydrogen, how many is there? 3 plus 2, 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 3, 10. C4H10 is the molecular formula for butane. Now we have to draw the isomer for butane. Isomer means what? It will have. So we are going to draw the isomers. So here all the 4 carbons we have drawn in the straight line. Next, what I am going to do is 3 carbons I am going to draw in the straight line and 1 carbon I am going to draw in the branch. 3 carbons I am going to draw in the straight line and 1 carbon I am going to draw in the branch. So now how many hydrogens you should put for this carbon, tell me? This carbon is having only 1 bond, so for remaining 3 bonds I should put 3 hydrogens. What about this carbon? Already it is having 3 bonds, so remaining only 1 bond it needs, so remaining only 1 hydrogen. For this carbon, only 1 bond is there, so remaining 3 bonds, so I should put 3 hydrogen. For this carbon also only 1 bond is there, so I will put 3 hydrogen. So what is the name of this compound? If it is a branched compound, I have to name the branch first. So So in the branch, how many carbons are there? One carbon. So one carbon means it is meth. For branch, the suffix is YL, methyl. Position of the branch. For position, I have to number from this side and I have to number from this side. So when you number from this side also, the branch is getting the position number 2 only. When you number from this side also, it is getting position 2 only. So it is 2-methyl. Remaining how many carbons are there? 3 carbons. So 3 carbons means it is pro. Single bond means it is 8. 2-methyl propane is the name of this compound. Now I am going to write the molecular formula for this. What is the molecular formula? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon. C4. Okay. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 3, 10. H10. So you can see both these compounds are having same molecular formula, but they are having different structure. So they are called as what? Isomers. Okay, so if the compounds are having same molecular formula but different structure, they are called as isomers. So these two are the isomers of butane. Okay, they are the isomers of butane. So next we have to draw the isomers of pentane, then we have to draw the isomers of hexane. Okay. So next we are going to draw the isomers of pentane. Isomers of pentane. So first we should draw pentane. Pent means how many carbons?
5
carbons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. A means fully single bond. Okay, fully single bond. Now for this carbon, how many hydrogens will come? 3 hydrogens, because it is having only one bond, so I will put only 3 hydrogens. So remaining 3 bonds, so 3 hydrogens. For this carbon, 2 hydrogens. For this carbon, 2 hydrogens. For this carbon, 2. And for this carbon, 3. So CH3, CH2, 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 CH3. This is the formula for pentane. What is the name? Pentane. What is the molecular formula for this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So C5H, 3 plus 2, 5, plus 2, 7, plus 2, 9, 9 plus 3, 12. So C5H12 is the molecular formula. So first what I have done, all the 5 carbons, I have put it in the straight line. So next what I should do, 4 carbons, I have to put it in the straight line. And one carbon in the branch. Okay, 4 carbons in the straight line and one carbon in the branch. So here how many will come?
3.
3H3. For this carbon, it is already having 3 bonds. So only one more bond. So put only one hydrogen. For this carbon, 2 bonds. So remaining 2 hydrogens. For this carbon, 3 hydrogens. And for this carbon also 3 hydrogens. So what will be the name of this compound? First you have to name the branch. So in the branch there is only one carbon. So one carbon means it is meth. For branch group it is YL, methyl. So next position, number from this side and number from this side. When you number from this side, the branch is getting the position 2. When you number from this side, the branch is getting the position 3. Always you should take the least number. 2 is only the least number. So I will write 2-methyl. So remaining how many carbons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. So 4 carbons means it is but single bond. Means it is in. So 2-methyl butane. Okay. So what is the molecular formula for this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So C5, hydrogen, 3 plus 1, 4, plus 2, 6, plus 3, 9, plus 3, 12. So C5H12. Okay. So this is one more isomer for pentane. So next what I am going to do is three carbons in the straight line and two carbons in the branch I am going to draw. So I am going to put three carbons in the straight line and two carbons in the branch like this. Okay, so here how many hydrogens will come? Three hydrogens. Here how many hydrogens will come? Already it is having four bonds, so we need not put any hydrogen here. Here how many hydrogens will come?
Three.
Okay, here three, and here also three. Okay, so here two branches are there. So in this branch only one carbon is there. Only one carbon means it is methyl branch. In this branch also only one carbon is there. So this is also methyl branch. So if two methyl branches are there, I will write it as dimethyl. Three methyl branches na trimethyl, four na tetramethyl. So two methyl branches, so I am writing it as dimethyl. So for both the branches I should put the position. So number from this side, number from this side. In whichever way in number the branches are getting the number 2 only. So this branch also is in position 2, this branch also is in position 2. So 2 comma 2, for both the branches you should write the number. 2 comma 2 dimethyl, remaining how many carbons are there?
3.
So 3 means it is pro, single bond, so 8. So 2 comma 2 dimethyl propane is the name of this isomer. What is the molecular formula? C5 hydrogen 3. So 3 12 will come. Okay, C5H12. So all the compounds are having same molecular formula, but they are having different structure and name. Okay, so they are all called as what? Isomers. Okay, so this isomers of pentane only many times they have asked in the exam. Okay, what are isomers, and draw the isomers of pentane, many times they have asked in the exam. Okay, butane and hexane only rarely they have asked, but pentane many times they have asked. Okay, so shall we draw for hexane?
Yes, sir.
Isomers of hexane. Isomers of hexane. So first we should draw hexane. Hex means how many carbons will come?
Six
carbons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So N means all are single bonds. Okay. So here how many hydrogens will come? Only one bond is there. So remaining 3 bonds. So 3 hydrogens. Here how many?
2.
Here also 2. Here also 2. Here also 2 and here 3. So this is my hexane. So my molecular formula will be C6H14. C6H14 is my molecular formula. Okay. Now in the first time I have written all the 6 carbons in the straight line. Next what I should do? 5 carbons in the straight line and 1 carbon in the branch. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons in the straight line and 1 carbon in the branch. In this itself, I will have 2 cases. You see, 5 carbons in the straight line like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons in the straight line, 1 carbon I have to put it in the branch. So the branch can be in the second position or the branch can be in the third position. The branch can be in the second position or I can draw the branch in the third position. So in this itself I am having how many cases? 2 cases. So now you have to fill both the things and write the names for both the things. So write down here CH3, here one hydrogen will come, here CH2, CH2, CH3, here CH3, here CH3, CH2, CH3, CH2, CH3. Okay, now what is the name? First I have to name the branch. So in the branch there is only one carbon, so it is meth. Okay, so YL. So what is the position? 1, 2, second position. If a number from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is the greater number, we will not take. Okay, so 1, 2. So 2 methyl. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons means pent. Single bond means end. So 2 methyl pentane. So if you count this also, you will get the molecular formula C6H14. Okay. Now for this one, branch one carbon is there, so it is meth. So for branch it is methyl. Okay, so what is the position? 1, 2, 3rd position. When a number from that side also, I will get number 3 only. So it is 3 methyl, remaining 5 carbons. 5 carbons means pent, single bond means end, pentane. So it is C6H14. Okay, now all the 6 carbons in straight line, all the 5 carbons in straight line, one branch in the second position, 5 carbons in straight line, one branch in the third position, like this I have drawn. Now next what I should do, 4 carbons in the straight line and 2 in the branch, like that I have to draw. Okay. So, 4 carbons in the straight line and 2 in the branch. So, in this itself, I will have 2 cases. What I should get? 2 branches I should get. So, these 2 branches can be like this in the different carbon. Or these 2 branches can be in the same carbon also. The 2 branches can be in the different carbon, or the 2 branches can be in the same carbon also. Okay. So fill it with hydrogen. CH3, CH, CH, CH3, CH3, CH3. Like this you will get. So what will be the name of this compound? So I will draw this little bit down. What will be the name of this compound? Tell me.
Two
branches are there. So branches we have to name first. So in this branch also one carbon. So this is the methyl branch. In this branch also only one carbon. So this is also methyl branch. So 2 methyl branches means it is dimethyl. What will be the position? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. If I number from this side, one branch is getting the number 2, another branch is getting the number 3. If I number from this side, one branch is getting the number 2 and another branch is getting the number 3. So 2, 3 only you are getting. So 2, 3 dimethyl. Remaining how many carbons are there? 4. 4 means butte, single bond means end, and the molecular formula will be C6H14. Okay. So now you try for this one, here you will get CH3, here already 4 bonds, you will not get any hydrogen. So CH3, CH3, CH2, CH3. Okay, so now you see here, so 2 branches, so 2 branches, and this is a methyl branch, this is also methyl branch. So 2 methyl branches means you should write it as dimethyl, and both the branches are in which position?
2.
Second position. When you number from this side, you will get third position. Always you should take the least number. So this branch also is in number 2. This branch also is in number 2. So 2, 2 dimethyl, remaining 4 carbons. So 4 carbons means butane.
Butane.
Okay. So you will get C6H14. So some students will have doubt. We are putting one branch in the second carbon and third carbon. Why we are not putting the branch in the fourth carbon? There is no fourth carbon at all. You know, fourth carbon, if I put the branch here, when I number from this side, I will get 4. But when I number from this side, I will get the number 2. Again, I will take the least number 2. Again, I will get 2 methyl pentane only. Understood? So there is nothing called as the fourth position. Okay, only second position and third position is there. Suppose if I draw, instead of here, if I draw the branch here, you cannot say it is fourth position. Yes or no? Because when I number from this side, I will get the number 2. So again, it is 2 methyl pentane. The same thing only you will get. Okay. So understood? So these are all the isomers of hexane. So they are having same molecular formula but different structural formula. This is also a very important question. So the remaining things I will continue in the next class.